goddamn respect in this town.
What's going on, guys? It's K-Dub here with another episode of Crypto Zombie. Welcome back to the channel. Hope you're having a wonderful day today. Now, Bitcoin did get up to $69,000 on a few different exchanges. We have had a slight pullback since then. We did have a bounce. In fact, if you watched my previous video, we bounced exactly at the levels that we had looked at. We'll get to the chart in just a bit, but having a look at what did happen right here, essentially, we had what we refer to as a bit of a Darth Maul wick. You could see we had all the way up to the top here, and then it came all the way down to the bottom here, and we call this the Darth Maul wick because it looks like the Darth Maul double-ended lightsaber, right, where you have this high wick all the way up here and this low wick all the way down here. This pretty much wipes out leverage on the long side as well as the short side, but nevertheless, this is actually somewhat of a good thing because it does help reset funding, but we do need to talk about something major that is coming up for Bitcoin in 3 days that could have some severe impact, maybe short term, on the price. So I do want to talk about that specific event. You are going to want to stick around to hear about this. It's probably going to affect all of us in the crypto space, regardless of what coins you are involved in. Now, we have seen that Ethereum has actually been performing extremely well, doing exactly what we thought it was going to do, continuing on this upwards parabolic trend. So we are going to talk about Bitcoin. We are going to talk about Ethereum. I want to talk about why we may have actually seen this sort of mini crash for Bitcoin. There are a few factors we're going to go over that are very important to pay attention to. I also want to talk about strategies for maximizing gains in this bull run, all right? There are a lot of people in the crypto space, and you know, if you're new, you're probably just throwing your money at every single coin out there. Well, billionaire investor Stanley Druckenmiller did come out with a bit of a warning, and I do also want to emphasize that warning as well, but also let you know one of the easiest strategies to help you maximize gains in this bull run, as well as, of course, I have two more altcoins I am going to share with you at the end of this video. Timestamps are below. If you like TA, if you like news, if you like altcoins, all of that will be below. So stick around and let's dive in immediately. And if you're not subscribed, well, of course, you know what to do. Turn on that bell notification. So let's have a look at Bitcoin. So we already went over this Darth Maul wick right here. You could see from the top all the way down to the bottom, Bitcoin actually fell about almost 10%, 9.5%. Currently, we're only down 6% from that level. But you know, it wasn't just Bitcoin. You can also see that we did, in fact, have the S&P having a bit of a pullback as well. Now, why has this happened? Well, let me first, before we get into the charts, let's talk about what's happening. There's a few things that could be affecting stocks, crypto, gold, the whole financial space in general. Now, one thing that might have just spooked some investors was the fact that Elon Musk did, in fact, sell $5 billion of his Tesla shares. You can see by having a look at the Tesla chart, I don't have it pulled up. Obviously, Tesla was not safe from this pullback either. This was his first sale since 2016. But one of the things outside of our good old buddy Elon Musk that has some investors spooked is what is going on in Asia right now. So you might be familiar with the ongoing debate over the Evergrande debacle, all right? This is the Chinese property giant. So there was essentially this news that said they might have had to default on their $148 million bond payment, which did send prices dropping around 5% across the board. Bitcoin itself right now, as I showed you, is currently down 6%. Now, at the last minute during the grace period, they were able to take care of this, but it did, in fact, shake the markets just a little bit. We also had more Tether FUD coming out. So essentially what was going on was they were talking about Tether's reserves being made up of commercial paper amounting to nearly $30 billion. This is enough for the Financial Times to place Tether among global giants in the category. This is nothing new. We've been talking about the Tether FUD for a while, but hey, you know, every so often somebody's got to bring it up again. Did this have something to do with it? It may have had something to do with it, but you also have legendary billionaire investor Stanley Druckenmiller coming out and warning against cryptos, meme stocks, meme coins, and many other assets. He says that they might actually just be overpriced. He actually compares it to the dot-com bubble, but says that this time around it's even more speculative than the dot-com bubble was. And he says that that too many people are investing with a short-term mindset rather than a long-term mindset. He says he always looks into something that he believes will continue to increase over the next 18 months. Now, before you guys freak out, he did invest in Bitcoin. He is looking to hold Bitcoin long-term. You could see right here, he says the US dollar will lose world reserve currency status, right? This is according to Bitcoin Magazine. So he is seeing dire times for the US dollar. Now, I know that we have talked about the, you know, inflation situation. Now, the Fed has said that they're going to start tapering. But if we just look at the numbers alone, this is just an article from The Guardian, not even a crypto website. And they say that inflation has surged in the US, China, and Germany. In the US, consumer prices rose at an annual rate of 6.2% in just October, the highest since 1990, while the core rate excluded food and energy picked up to 4.6%, the highest since 1991. You could see US inflation jumps to a 31-year high amid global supply chain crisis. And it's not just the US, it is the entire world. And this is why we are seeing so many nations, like for example, even El Salvador, high net worth individuals moving away, even from taking that chunk out of the gold market, moving into the Bitcoin market, which is why I do believe personally that Bitcoin is still the number one hedge against all inflation. And anybody that says it's going to start going the other way, or it's not going to continue, they're just blowing smoke up your you know what. It is going to continue. And this is why I still do believe that Bitcoin is the best asset. But talking about the chart right here, is there still that potential for pullback? Absolutely. In fact, crypto is infamously known for 30% correction. So if you're new, just know that one of these days, you're probably going to wake up and see your portfolio cut in half. Now, how do you prepare for something like this, though? Do you just hold? Well, that is an excellent strategy, especially for Bitcoin. You could see right here, talking on the short term, and I will get back to that in just a minute, we had a perfect bounce off of this level that we had at around $63,000. In fact, it only wicked just a few dollars below it. So if you were looking to make money trading using leverage, I essentially told you guys the exact level I was looking at. We had the bounce directly off that level. So if you did take an opportunity to get into a position at that level, obviously put your stop losses where, you know, where it's appropriate for you for your own risk management. But that was an excellent call, guys. And congratulations to everybody that took that trade. If you don't know what I'm talking about and you want to learn how to trade Bitcoin using leverage, definitely check out the tutorial popping up above. There's also a ton of links below in the description of this video, but let's talk about what is happening right now. Why the pullback from 69,000? Well, there was a massive increase in Bitcoin margin futures open interest this afternoon. Traders going long, Bitcoin with Bitcoin as collateral. Dylan LeClaire, he says, no free lunch. These traders are in the process of being shaken out. And I told you guys, this is a good thing, right? Not only does it shake out weak hands, but it also allows the funding rates to reset to healthy levels. You don't want these funding rates getting out of control. That's when you have these insane market price swings, right? Also having a look right here. So you do have Eric Bolchunas. Now he says, here's spot Bitcoin daily change versus BITO, which is the ETF, last few days. This is solid tracking, blows away any other publicly traded equity in terms of correlation to Bitcoin. And even looking at this right here, you know, he goes on to say, the option volume today on BITO was massive for a new launch. It's also been growing quickly, can see via the averages. For context, it's already seeing about half of the options volume as gold, which is stud level. And I told you, there were a lot of investors moving out of gold. Let's be honest, gold has not been performing the way that it should be, considering the rampant inflation. Yet Bitcoin and cryptocurrencies have clearly been stealing the show, and we have the data to prove it, right? We also had Anthony Scaramucci saying that investors are literally lining up in droves just waiting or attempting to buy Bitcoin, and he says they can't even keep up with all of the demand, right? They're trying to get these orders in by 2022. So that's something to consider. Now, as far as how you can play these markets, we know that Bitcoin is known for these 30%, 40%, heck, we had a 55% pullback here, right? And we did have a beautiful bounce off the 50-day moving average. So if we were to fall hypothetically from prices today down to that level, that would would be about that would literally be a 31% correction, which would be very, very normal to see to happen in Bitcoin. And that would bring Bitcoin down to $45,000 while also maintaining an upwards trend. So this would still be bullish even if we had a 30% correction for Bitcoin. But what can you do? If you have all of your funds tied up in, you know, all these crazy assets, you have no way to buy the dip. So this is something that a lot of people do not do in bull runs because they say, I don't need to do this. Why should I have a cash position? Why should I be sitting in stable coins? But the reality is how are you going to buy the dip if you don't have dry powder to buy the dip, right? So the best strategy essentially in a bull run is buying the dips. But the key word there is buy. You have to be able to actually have funds to buy the dip. So it's always good to have a bit of a cash position, whether it be stable coins or whatever that you prefer, keep it in your bank account, then buy on Coinbase, whatever you choose to do. But having maybe a 10% just allocation to cash or to stable coins will allow you to be able to buy these dips. And you don't have to deploy everything all at once. If we get a 30% crash, maybe you go in with 50%, right? And then as we go up, we have the next pullback, then you can put more money in. But you definitely need to have some kind of a strategy. There are so many people that get involved in crypto and they have literally no strategy whatsoever. So that is a very, very simple strategy that you can do: buy the dips, but have some capital allocated on the side, right? Also, a lot of people ask me about my exit strategy. What is my exit strategy for crypto? If you want me to make an exit strategy video, I will. The truth is, I'll probably never, ever sell all of my Bitcoin ever, because why would I? But of course, you do want to take profits at certain points in time. And we will talk about how we can identify, you know, sort of the end of the market, when we can tell that this is the top. You know, a lot of people back here laughed at me, you know, when I said that this wasn't the top, the Pi Cycle indicator was calling it. Now, granted, yes, if you had sold, you would have made a lot of money had you bought back in here again. But today we're sitting even higher than those levels. So to the non-savvy investor or the person who simply doesn't want to be day trading, let's be honest, buying and holding once again has been the strategy for Bitcoin, right? So what is the big news? Well, this is something we need to talk about, and this is happening in 3 days. So on November 14th, we have the Securities and Exchange Commission of the U.S. is going to give its final decision on the approval or the disapproval of the first physically backed Bitcoin ETF in the U.S. You can see right here, here's the ETF timeline, November 14th, SEC's final decision for the VanEck Bitcoin ETF. Now, why is this so important? Who cares? We already have an ETF, right? Yes, but the ETF that we have right now is not backed by Bitcoin. It's Bitcoin futures that are cash settled. So these are cash settled, not Bitcoin settled, which means nobody has to actually touch any Bitcoin. This doesn't do anything for the demand increase of Bitcoin. They don't have to hold any Bitcoin in their custody. But if we get a physically backed Bitcoin ETF, this would require VanEck to actually physically hold actual Bitcoin for this ETF, for the people that are getting involved, which means that this is going to increase the demand of Bitcoin insanely. We've already seen the supply shock. We've already seen Bitcoin getting taken off of exchanges. We've already seen the hodlers holding. Okay, let's be real right here. Anybody that basically bought at any time, except for what, the last week or so, is in profit. And yet we are not seeing a massive dump. We are not seeing massive sell-offs. We're just seeing healthy corrections, healthy bounces, right? Not to say we can't have that 30% crash imminently, potentially. Could this be buy the rumor, sell the news? Or could this actually be an event where the news will have a big impact? Because if we actually get the news that we are getting an ETF that is physically settled, that is huge, guys. That is a first of its kind, and that is absolutely massive for the space. So we have to keep our eyes on this. We have to pay attention. Now, long term, is it going to affect the Bitcoin price? Probably not. Short term, could get a little bit turbulent, especially if this does get denied. Now, on the flip side, we have seen Ethereum absolutely crushing it. Ethereum did not get hit nearly as much as some of the other coins. You could see right here from Watcher.guru, we had 844,000 Ethereum, roughly $4 billion worth, have been burned since the EIP 1559 upgrade. With all the usage, with all the fees and all the transactions and the DeFi and the NFTs, we are actually seeing a deflationary situation for Ethereum, which in my opinion is explaining why we are continuing to see Ethereum grow and grow. Which, by the way, guys, once again, I did tell you Just simply follow this trend. This trend has not been broken yet. The trend is your friend until the end. As I showed you guys every single time, Ethereum comes down to this levels, it bounces. So as I said right here, you add to your long, 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 obviously you have a stop loss, but this is what I'm talking about. And if you did buy down here, then from the dump to the top right now, and if we even just take it from the line, I won't even go all the way down, that's 4%. You're doing 4% with 3x leverage. Okay, that's 12%. Or if you wanna get crazy and do 10%, which I really wouldn't suggest that, but you could have been up 40% on just this move overnight, which is why I said, guys, if you are interested, please take advantage of not only the bonuses below, but also make sure you watch the tutorials so you understand. I have incredibly in-depth tutorials for three of the major exchanges. You can see one popping up right here. Please take the time to learn, be careful, and do not use your real funds in the beginning. Use a test account, learn what you're doing. But I mean, guys, I'm giving you these every single day. I'm telling you exactly what I'm looking for on these moves, and perfect bounces on Ethereum. And if we go back to Bitcoin, perfect bounce at the level that we spoke about. If you want to know the next levels, if Bitcoin does pull back, well, we have one at 62,300, which is the 21 exponential. And we have probably the most significant short term, which is $61,080, which is the VPVR, the highest volume traded level of Bitcoin since we formed this asymmetrical triangle, right? So, you know, get subscribed, watch the videos, turn on the bell notifications. I'm bringing this to you every day, maybe not every single day, but I always bring it to you, when I feel it needs to be brought to attention. In fact, I told you we were going to have this breakout here. I made the video like 3 days before the breakout. People in the comments are like, urgent video. What's so urgent about it? Well, guys, when do you want me to tell you about the breakout? Do you want me to tell you when it's happening? Or do you want me to let you know that we're leaning towards a breakout move? Okay, because I want to get you guys prepared for the move. I don't think it's fair if I just tell you the day of, like, oh, there we go. So the idea is to be prepared. Be prepared for the moves if you're trading. Be prepared for the pullbacks with stablecoins on the side. And also be prepared for the blast off of these altcoins in the future, right? So talking about some of these altcoins, some of them that I spoke about the other day on my channel were smart contract platforms. Smart contract platforms are going to perform well in this bull run. They always perform well in the bull run. Now, maybe you're not going to get 40x gains or 50x gains, but having a look at something like Solana right here, you know, sitting at around a $72 million market cap, I mean, you could still see, you know, 5x returns, 10x returns in just Solana. Cardano's been sitting around the $2 level for how long? And now that there's a lot of things coming to Cardano, people are getting excited. Avalanche as well, Chainlink doing very well this week, 11% in just 7 days. Algorand, Polygon, Matic, I've told you guys about that. So that is what you can look at. Now, something I've not talked about really much on my channel is Cardano. Now, I don't mean to obviously offend everyone, but for a while, let's be real, Cardano was just a lot of promises, right? This is gonna happen eventually, we're gonna be doing this, but nothing was really coming to fruition. Now, just like we're seeing on Polkadot, just like we're seeing on Solana, we finally have projects that are looking to build on Cardano, Ardana. Now, shout out, I can't remember who made this over on Twitter. This is a nice infographic made by one of the community members. And they talk about Ardana, which is going to be the first all-in-one stablecoin ecosystem built on Cardano. And they're going to have Dana Swap, and they're also going to have the Dana token. So if you have a look over here at the website, this is something that interests me. I am very interested in being first, getting in at the ground level. This is a first, right, that I'm aware of. Maybe there's another project that I have not heard of, but a stablecoin ecosystem on Cardano, this is something that is going to be very, very important, especially for Cardano as an ecosystem whole. And the Dana token, which is obviously not out yet, but keep your eyes on it, they are going to be using this token essentially for the governance model of the platform. So, you know, there could be some value in the Dana token. So this is something to keep your eyes on, right? And this is Cardano. This is a platform I've not spoken about too much, but I definitely think that this is interesting. They're going to have the DUSD, which is verifiably backed by on-chain collateral and will enable borrowers to take leverage on their ADA or other supported assets. Another project, now this is over on Polkadot that we talked about. I told you guys about Kilt a while ago. These guys basically have gone fully decentralized, right? So from now on, it's going to be run via sophisticated system of governance. And until now, you had the pseudo key module that allowed the development team to make necessary changes, but now it's essentially given to the Kilt community. So this is another project to keep your eyes on. This is in the Polkadot ecosystem. I spoke about this a while ago. Kilt is another project I'm very, very excited for. And This is it. This is the moment that everyone's gonna say something. So you guys know how I felt about XRP on this channel. I haven't exactly been the biggest XRP advocate. For my own personal reasons, this is not particularly a coin that I've been interested in, but I do respect the XRP community, and I respect what Ripple is trying to do for the space. And this right here has to be some of the biggest news. Now, we know that they are having a lawsuit right now, which, by the way, if it does turn out to be in Ripple's favor, dare I say you may want to own some XRP, because it's probably going to absolutely skyrocket, not only for XRP, but for crypto as a whole. I believe if they win this case, it's going to not only just be good for XRP and Ripple, I think it's going to be good for crypto as a whole. And now they just announced that they're going to be launching Ripple Liquidity Hub, which will allow enterprises to access and source liquidity from the broader crypto market for a range of cryptocurrencies, including XRP, and get this, Bitcoin and Ethereum as well. This is massive. This is huge, guys, especially for people who are extremely in the Ripple XRP camp, right? Down here, you can see with the launch of the Ripple Liquidity Hub to be launched in 2022, enterprise customers will be able to use an API connection to access digital assets from a variety of global sources, including market makers, exchanges, over-the-counter desks, and in the future, decentralized ventures as well. Wow. So to put things in a perspective, you can think of Liquidity Hub as an aggregator for various liquidity venues and individual assets, the way that Google Flights is for airlines and flights. So I know today's video had a lot of information. We had so much we needed to go over, but I just wanted to let you guys know, have a strategy. You know, don't just be throwing darts, at the board and hoping for the best. Can it work sometimes? Sure, especially in the mania phase. But if you want to make the absolute most money in this space during this bull run, you have to have that strategy, having some dry capital, some dry powder, some cash on the side, right? So that you can actually buy the dips. Also, as I told you, invest, not financial advice, but, have an allocation to some of these higher tier projects. Okay, maybe they're not going to give you the 40x, 50x gains, but looking at these ecosystems, Solana, Cardano, Avalanche, Chainlink, Algorand, I could go down here, Phantom as well, Elrond. I always forget Elrond. And Kadena, these guys, 200% increase. Wish I had a look into that. I unfortunately missed that one. That one came out of left field for me personally. But if you are invested in that, congratulations. But so anyway, guys, that's all. I don't want to go on too much for today's video, but I like to just bring you, you guys know how these videos go. I try to bring you the updates of everything, right? We go over TA, we go over fundamentals, we go over altcoins to keep your eyes on, and also strategies occasionally. But like I said, guys, if you are looking to trade these markets, make sure that you definitely watch the videos that are going to pop up here at the end, because we go over this. You can use test accounts, and every single day I am showing you the exact levels that I'm looking at. I mean, every single day. So anyway, guys, thank you so much for coming back to the channel. You guys rock. I love you. Be safe out there. And a 30% correction is not out of the cards. A $45,000 Bitcoin is not out of the cards. But the thing is even if we were to fall down to some of those levels, we're still in an upwards trend. We're still putting in higher lows. This thing is not done yet, okay? We are most likely going to see a $100,000 Bitcoin by the end of this year. I'm not going to make that prediction, but by the end of this cycle, yes, absolutely. I 100% believe we're going to see $100,000 Bitcoin before the end of this cycle. You can quote me on that if you want. But that being said, guys, that is enough. Today's video has been long enough. Thank you so much for coming back to the channel. Get subscribed. Drop a comment. I love to read the comments. I love to hear your opinion on the matter. And if you guys have any altcoins that you think I should look at, you guys know I'm always open to the community. I do take your suggestions, and I do look into them, and sometimes we do find some gems out there together. So thank you so much for coming back to the channel. My name is K-Dub. This is Crypto Zombie. And of course, if you haven't checked out these videos right here, do yourself a favor, click them, check them out. Until next time, stay crypto. And of course, peace out.